accommodation, facilitating resources to our communities. Legacies of the past had to be mitigated, and I am proud to say that the city of Ekurhuleni is excelling in this regard. Planning for the Eugenistic Fire Station was started in 2013-14 financial year, and today the city of Ekurhuleni is happy to announce the delivery of this new fire station, and want to say to you as members of the community, in order for it to service this particular community. We know that there are a number of challenges here, especially around the areas of Dugatole and so on. So we want to ensure that minimizing the response time to different communities is a key objective in saving the lives in the city. The costs of the newly built structure amount to about 56 million rand, which investment is to the business community and the residents at large. And that is why it's important for us to say to you, you must protect this facility. Not forgetting the neighboring cities as well. The fire station will serve the community in and around Jemistin CBD, which will include but not limited to the following areas. The CBD of Jemistin, including the new and upgraded housing project that is just behind you here. We've spent millions of rands building a facility so that we can bring the community closer to the areas where they are working. The Jemistin precinct, the mining belt, including Dugatole and the Good Hope informal settlement. Various industrial areas that are surrounding the CBD of Jemistin, as well as the airport. You will recall that last month, to be specific, on the 5th and 6th of September, when the city of Johannesburg had a massive structural fire in the city, and the resources of the city were deployed there under the instruction of the mayor to ensure that we can mitigate the challenges then that was faced by firefighters of Johannesburg. Since the arrival of our resources on site, 20 men and women whom had an opportunity to honor as a city, they made sure that the fire is extinguished at all. The hydraulic platform that is standing outside here, similar to the one that assisted us in powering enough water supply in the Bank of Building, Bank of Lisbon building that was on fire in the city of Johannesburg. The city of Ekurhuleni is also launching its fire fleet today, which will be deployed in various fire stations in and around the city of Ekurhuleni. Throughout the city, we are now investing over 37 million rand to ensure that the purchasing of two times major pumpers, one rescue pumper, two water tankers, and one heavy rescue vehicle to add a cost of about 37 million rand. For the successful implementation of disaster and emergency management services, the plan of the city of Ekurhuleni requires pertinent resources. Today, we are also proud to announce the new fleet of vehicles to mitigate our objective of the city. The city will further spend an additional 33 million rand in purchasing the new durable ambulances, which will also serve the entire city. The ambulances consist of 87 ambulances. Some, I'm sure, you will have an opportunity to, when we do a tour, to see them here, and six times emergency response cars that will accompany the ambulances. Due to the water-related difficulties at this point in time, the city also thought of utilizing the available water resources around the city, especially the dams and lakes and open water streams, to fast track the needs in case of huge structural fires. Hence, the city is now launching a new high-volume water relay system, which is one of its kind in Africa. So today, we have an opportunity here in 185 to witness that high-volume water relay system in our own city of Ekurhuleni. This is because the city of Ekurhuleni is an economical hub of Gauteng as a province, if not of the Republic at large. So it's therefore important for us to ensure that if there are such events, we are able as a city to respond adequately to serve industries, amongst other things. This water transfer system includes the engine, specialized water pump, and hoses, which can supply about 24,000 liters of water per minute and transport water for a distance of about 5 kilometers with enough pressure. The city is building towards a life safety strategy and the property of saving mechanisms to lure more business opportunities in a safe environment. We know that our people continue to experience a high level of unemployment. So the high water, the high volume water lake alone costed the city about 28 million rand, and therefore we want to appeal, especially to members of the community, to make sure that we work together to save these facilities, because they should be here for generations to come, for us to continue utilizing them so that we can keep our communities safe, including the surroundings of our cities here. We want to take the opportunity to congratulate the MMC and the team for the work well done, including the oversight committee for continuously ensuring that they keep us as a representative in check in terms of all the work that we are doing. We are confident that over the next coming 5 years, the city of Ekurhuleni will have sufficient facilities that are going to ensure safer communities around our area. I want to take this opportunity to thank you as members of the community and say it is now, this facility is now in your hands. Make sure that you protect it with everything possible so that we can always ensure that we benefit in terms of services in the main. Thank you very much, everyone.